Hello. Several years ago, I was a member of the Senin Resistance, the old Calendarist jurisdiction founded by the late Metropolitan Kyprian Phi Lee, and I visited one of their monasteries in California called St. Gregory Palamas Monastery, and I want to share with you people a couple experiences I had during my visits. I remember one day that I was in the printing room, and I was working in there with some monks, and Archbishop Chrysostomos walked in, and something had happened. Something went wrong. I don't remember what it was. Something didn't go right with him. Something he was doing didn't go right, or something. I don't remember the details about it, but what I do remember is that he was upset, and he took the name of Jesus Christ in vain. He said it loudly. He was facing us, and apparently he disregarded the fact that we could possibly be offended or scandalized by him taking the name of our Lord in vain. I could not believe it. I was very shocked because I had come out of evangelicalism, and I had never in my life seen a pastor. I had never seen a theologian or an evangelical leader of any kind take the name of Jesus Christ in vain. I could not believe it. And another time, I don't know if it was during the same visit or another visit, I also witnessed Archbishop Chrysostomos take the name of Christ in vain. So I could not force myself to take these people seriously on spiritual and Christian matters. No, it's just simply not going to happen, and I always knew there was something wrong with those people. So I really heard this and witnessed this with my own ears, people, and this is a bad sign. I personally believe that it's a sign of the demonic energy that works with these people that is causing them to be in schism from the Orthodox Church. I believe personally, and it's my opinion, I'm a very honest person, and I state when I'm giving my opinion. I personally believe that these men wanted their own jurisdiction for their own vanity. They wanted to have followers. They wanted to have people bow before them, kiss their hands, and call them Your Eminence and Your Grace for their own vain purposes. I believe the system is completely and absolutely spurious, and I don't think that they have the best interests of souls and of orthodoxy in mind. I think they just want to build their own jurisdiction for their own vanity. That's all my opinion, okay? So I really witnessed this. It is deplorable that a archbishop would take the name of Jesus Christ in vain. I've never heard any clergyman, not even in Roman Catholicism, Protestantism, Evangelicalism, or any Christian confession, ever take the name of Christ in vain. This is outrageous. So I want to say a few other words. I have a question. Who was Archbishop Chrysostomos ever under obedience to in the monastic life? That's a question I have. I'm not saying he did not have an abbot in his immediate monastic environment, but I'd like to know who he was, because from what I understand, he built the monastery with his own money. So I think he was always in the top position. I'm not talking about being under obedience to someone in Greece like Metropolitan Kyprian. I'm talking about who was his abbot in the monastic life? Who was he ever under obedience to? Because they put very hard rules, and they're very strict with their monks there. And it reminds me of the teaching of Christ about the Pharisees. They bind heavy burdens, grievous to be borne, but they do not lift them with one of their fingers. So I'm not saying Chrysostomos did not lift them with one of his fingers. I'm just saying that it seems like he put very strict rules on the monks there, and he just builds this monastery. He's automatically in a leadership position. And I would like to know who his abbot was. Was he ever under that kind of strict obedience for years in the immediate monastic environment and context? Who was his abbot? From what I understand, like I said, he started the monastery, and then Bishop Auxenius and Father Acacius joined him, but who was he ever under obedience to? That's my question. That's what I'd like to know. And again, I'm not saying he was not under obedience to someone in the monastic life and environment. I'm just asking the question, who is he and where is he? Where, who was this abbot and where is he now? So that's my question. I thank you for listening. I have more information below in the description box about this group. Thank you.